This project is part of a wider effort within the central region to improve water quality within the Sandy Creek catchment and also improve the efficacy of our inputs and how we use our fertilizers. The Sandy Creek area, which is just south of Mackay, which has come under a fair bit of environmental scrutiny more recently. And one of the issues was the ongoing detection of a chemical called imidicloprid. Now, imidicloprid is one of the key insecticides to control cane grubs, and the detection was causing a fair bit of angst amongst the growers simply because it's such a pivotal insecticide for cane grub control. So as a department, we thought, how can we be proactive and try and work out how we can improve the application? This is a fairly conventional applicator. You've got a lead coulter which cuts through the trash, followed by these two double disc openers. These double disc openers open up quite a large V in which the fertilizer and the insecticide is deposited into the ground down to about 125 millimeters. So this project was actually working out how can we better close the slot behind the applicator. EHS manufacturing and also Central Coast spreading to work collaboratively to be proactive in how we improve the application of this insecticide and also nitrogen products.
We went out to have a look at some of the sites where they've been applying it so we can visually see fertiliser in that groove caused by the steel splitter. Any rainfall event or irrigation, you're going to get a drain effect that's going to run that chemical straight out the end of the paddock and also minimise its efficiency as well. This is the end result of what we've come up with, but effectively what this does is it goes along the side of the open groove and it's breaking that side of that open groove. And we do have a slight plough effect on it as well to cover that groove completely with trash as well and effectively close that gap up, stop any runoff. And when you actually dig down to try and find the fertiliser and the chemical, it's mixed in with the dirt that well that it's really difficult to actually find it. Whereas on this open trench, you can visually see it.
It was easy to adapt this onto our existing machine, the way EHS have designed it, the way it bolts on, it's not hard to make it work. We found it's much easier in different soil conditions to end up with a nice, neat job. And as a contractor, that's our aim.
And if you don't close the slot effectively, you get degradation of the chemical through sunlight, and also you get a lot of ammonia loss through volatilization. This little machine has done 1,000 hectares and it certainly is doing a very, very good job under quite a different soil types and also different crop heights. Well, basically from here on in, EHS Manufacturing will put this design with all the blueprints up on their website. There's no IP attached to this project, so anyone can access this information and this data, and they can get these things built either by EHS or an alternative manufacturer. It's available for everyone. So I think we've achieved the one goal that we set out to effectively close the slot. I think we've done that. And the other projects run by different organizations within the region who are also being very proactive in trying to work out how they can further reduce the impacts of water quality issues with imidicloprid and also things like nitrate nitrogen.